this time, it's uncertain. Raila Odinga has not accurately gauged the public mood. The ongoing protests are, unlike any other, lacking a clear leader and continuously evolving in their methods of resisting the government. This movement isn't something to be taken lightly, guys. It's not something that you can take lightly, because we never know their plans. We are not understanding them yet. Like yesterday, they said they will camp in Uhuru Park, and then when they become 5 million people, they would march to State House. So I believe it is something that is a very big headache for the government itself. If the protests were driven by tribalism, they would have been easier to quash, and tribal-based movement would not have garnered a widespread support, a nationwide support, like you have protests everywhere. Similarly, if it were confined in a specific region, like let's say only Nairobi, the security forces would have swiftly suppressed it. However, the protest is different. It is a nationwide and often unpredictable, catching the government off guard. The true challenge for the government is the nature of the protests. They are peaceful and focused on specific issues, making it difficult to dismiss or undermine their legitimacy. The participants, primarily youth, are undeterred by threats to their lives. Many are prepared to make the ultimate sacrifice for their cause. Kenya has changed. The landscape of dissent is no longer confined by traditional boundaries of tribe or region. It is unified, issue-based. The movement has captured the spirit of the nation, signaling a new era of civic engagement and resistance. So guys, that is my take of a misjudged movement and Raila's oversight in the reading the room. He has not understood what is going on. So kindly let me know in the comments below, and you can subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, and let's keep moving. See you in the next video.